On June 5th, 2007, BBC News reported that some British police departments had decided to add officers on full moon nights. No, do not be afraid. Worries is not about wolves, vampires, or even a witch who was riding on broom. But more human threats, such as thieves. But what does this have to do with the full moon? Full moon. The moon and its possible impact on human behavior has been a subject of mystery of ancestors and myths for hundreds of years. Many folktales consider the full moon to be not only a source of unrest among humans, but also a source of more physical and mental change. Although plants need sunlight for photosynthesis, many ancient civilizations linked their growth to moonlight. Or the moon determines when women become pregnant. Hence, in many ancient civilizations, there is a symbol of the moon goddess. Perhaps this is because the human body has a 28 cycle of hormonal and physiological features, the most prominent of which is the female menstrual cycle. Maybe, but we cannot ignore the fact that more than 13% of women's menstruation occurs in the full moon. This is the result of a study conducted in 2011 on 826 women. And researchers in Kyoto, Japan, studied 1,000 births in private hospitals and found that the highest number of babies were born during the full moon. We see that ancient myths are not so far from the finding of modern researchers. On one hand, philosophers such as Aristotle and Pliny have stated that the full moon affects humans. Effects such as confusion, lack of boredom, or insomnia. And on the other hand, in 2013, a study was conducted in Switzerland that showed that the full moon has the ability to disrupt a normal sleep pattern. They found evidence of the moon effect on 33 volunteers in well-controlled condition. In full moon time, the researchers found that volunteers slept less and had lower quality sleep, while they were in the dark room with no windows and could not see the moon. Volunteers also experienced a severe drop in melatonin, a hormone produced by the pineal gland only in the dark of night. The tide is perhaps the best example of the moon's impact on the Earth. Because we are all familiar with it. Tides are the result of the moon's gravity, full moon. That is, when the sun, earth, and moon are all in the same direction. Of course, this gravity is not just specific to the oceans, because researchers have found that the full moon is directly related to the hypertension. And of course, this effect is not limited to humans, as researchers have also found that pets, such as ducks, exposed to full moonlight, need 28% more urgency than usual. But the attention of the ancients to the moon is not limited to these cases. Drawing down the moon is the name of a major tradition in Wiccans, the pagan witchcraft ritual. During the ceremony, the high priest enters a trance and requests that the trine goddess, the symbol of the moon, enter her body and speak through her. And it is said that during trance, it is the goddess who begins to speak through the high priest. Or it is seen in some ancient cultures that the moon was considered to be abode of gods or beings. But beyond the ancients, we will still come across strange things. Baron Franz von Paula was a Bavarian physician and astronomer. He was also professor of astronomy of the University of Munich in 1826. He made several observations of the lunar surface and found a city on the moon, which he named Valverde. He then published his observations, which were well received by astronomers of that time, but future astronomers denied his claims. But in 2018, NASA scientists used data from India's spacecraft Chandrayaan-1 to conclusively prove that icy water exists at the moon's poles. And 2 years later, in 2020, the Sofia Observatory confirmed for the first time the existence of water on the bright surface of the moon. This finding suggests that water may be distributed on the surface of the moon and is not limited to shady and cold places. We had indications that H2O, that is exactly the water on Earth, may be on the sunlit side of the moon. Now we know it's there. This discovery challenges our understanding of the lunar surface, said Paul Hirst, director of astrophysics of NASA. And of course, we know that water is the source of life. But Baron Franz was not only famous to make such a claim. Leading British astronomer Sir William Herschel also acknowledged that aliens live on the moon and made regular observations about the progress of their construction projects. What you see is not two pits, but a very wide pit. And a bridge with 7 meters wide and 20 meters long is located on it. This is what NASA says about this. Just when you think you have seen everything, the lunar orbiter shows a natural bridge over the moon. Who would have thought? Natural bridges on Earth are usually the result of wind and water erosion. Perhaps the question that is on your mind right now is whether there is life on the moon? Where did the moon come from, or how did it come into being? There is ample evidence that the moon is not what we are told, and there is also a lot of evidence to suggest that our planet once had no moon. Even some ancient civilizations speak of the time before the moon. Even Aristotle wrote in his notes that the Palestinians lived in the area long ago, since the moon did not exist. Believe it or not, not only NASA but other astronomers have nothing but a few theories about the origin of moon. And the most important of these theories says that the moon came into being when a planet size of Mars collided with Earth. That means completely coincidental. Well, listen to this now. The diameter of the Sun is 1.39 million kilometers, that is 109 times the size of the Earth. The diameter of the Moon is 3,474 kilometers. And this is the Earth with a diameter of 12,742 kilometers. The distance from the Earth to the Sun is 148 million kilometers. Earth's distance to the Moon, 384,000 kilometers. And the distance from the moon to the sun is about 148 million kilometers. When a total solar eclipse occurs, someone look at the event from the Earth. Look like the diameters of the moon and the sun are exactly the same. Not 1 meter bigger, not 1 meter smaller. Now, do you think the moon was made by chance? Thank you. But scientists say the moon has begun to move away from the Earth, meaning that it moves 4 cm away from the Earth annually, which means that the moon will eventually leave the Earth's orbit and become something called a planet. That is, a moon that has now become a planet orbiting the sun. Let's see what happens if there is no moon. At present, the deviation of the Earth is 23.5 degrees to the sun or away from it, depending on what season of the year we are. In 1993, Lascar, director of the CNRS, found that without the moon, the Earth's axial deflection would become more unstable over time, causing severe climate change. These conditions were problematic for the occurrence of biological evolution, or at least the occurrence of it in a different way. Well, in short, the moon affects the angle of inclinations of the Earth and affects life as we know it on Earth. The moon affects the oceans, the weather, and even the hours of our day. Without the moon, there will be no tides. The night will be darker, and most importantly, the seasons will change, and the Earth will experience extreme weather, and eventually, an ice age. Now let's take a look at the last ice age. Mitra, the god of creation of ancient Persia, appeared in the cave 11,000 years ago, in the last ice age. After killing a cow, he created the moon. And then he went to the heaven, and that was the end of the ice age. And we can see that geologists have discovered that the cave in Mount Damavan was the only place where humans were present and survived in the last ice age. It is not bad to take a look at one of the most mysterious events reported in human history. On the night of the 5th of May 1110, the moon appeared abnormally bright at night, and then gradually dimmed until it was completely disappeared, so that neither light nor sphere nor any of it could be seen, and so people did not have a moon in the sky for months. The Anglo-Saxon manuscript is one of the most complete accounts of this event. Well, in this case, the clouds were not a problem, because the scribe explained that the stars were fully visible when the moon faded. The moon was not under the shadow of the Earth either. If it were, the moon would turn into a bloody sphere. But in 2020, Sebastian Gullet of the University of Geneva attributed this to a volcano that has been active for years, while the Earth has witnessed the strongest volcanoes many times, but it has not witnessed the disappearance of the moon. Now, if we forgot the disappearance of the moon, what happens next is interesting. Torrential rains damaged crops and flooded almost all agricultural land. People struggled with hunger and cold until the moon reappeared in the sky. And note that this event was not specific to an area, a city, or a country. On November 20, 1969, Apollo 12 astronauts released a spacecraft to be sent to the moon. An unexpected thing happened after landing. The moon began to tremble for 1 hour due to the impact, just a bit, and it showed that the moon was hollow. Because if the whole moon was made of stone and rock, such a thing should not have happened. NASA then decided to crash harder for the Apollo 13 mission. And what they saw was the trembling of the moon for 3 hours. Many now believe that our moon is a hollow structure and an artificial satellite deliberately placed in Earth's orbit. Now we can understand the reason for these mysterious waves called the moon wave. In recent years, with the advancement of technology, humans have been able to produce better telescopes and have captured many images and films that show the presence of waves on the surface of the moon. You can watch a short video of the moon waves by clicking on the link in the description section. If you are curious to know if there is a life on the moon or not, well, astronomers deny the existence of life on the moon, but maybe long ago. However, there are conflicting reports on this issue. For example, the Apollo 11 mission.
Before this decade is out of landing a man on the moon and returning him safely to the Earth.
Apollo 11 was perhaps one of the most mysterious missions NASA has ever carried out.
I don't think we have any particular
On this mission, Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin were the first and second to walk on the moon. Upon returning to Earth, Aldrin claimed to have seen an alien spacecraft suspended while watching them land. This led to these astronauts being tested for lie detector.
Not just this
in
quiet,
fact,
but
there was no news of this claim until in April 2018. Daily Star published an article entitled, "I Saw a UFO, Buzz Aldrin Passes Lie Detector Test, Revealing Truth About Aliens." And stated in the article, "There was something out there that was close enough to be observed, sort of L-shaped." And there are dozens of videos from amateur and advanced cameras that show flying objects moving towards the moon or passing through the moon. You can watch some of them by clicking on the link in the description section.